was born in the summer of his 27th year, coming home to a place he'd never been before. He left yesterday behind him. You might say he was born again. You might say he found the key for every door.
Sun produces the energy for the house. The PV, the sun hits those photovoltaic panels. There are 16 of them, 175 watts each. The panels just to the west of those two panels, produce the hot water heat. So glycol runs through those panels. The sun heats the glycol, goes into the utility room, and makes the hot water heating system. So the energy, DC energy, direct current, comes from those panels, comes through the ground, through the conduit, goes to this side of the inverter. This is the charge controller. The charge controller decides whether the energy should go directly to the house if there's a demand, or if it should charge the batteries. And the house has first priority, the batteries have second priority. These batteries are reclaimed batteries. They actually are reclaimed from Enron. They were bought, put into a warehouse. Enron went bankrupt, and then I was able to buy these batteries 7 years later, never used. There's a huge amount of storage capacity in these batteries, 2,800 amp hours at 48 volts. What that means to an everyday person is that we could have no sun for 7 days and four people could live here and only be down to half of the capacity of what the house needs. Of course, in Colorado, we have 330 days of sunshine a year, so we never have 7 days without sun. The energy is then transformed into from DC to AC energy through these two inverters. Then it goes to the AC side of the panel, and from there it's just like a normal house. This would be the equivalent of a power plant. Runs into the electrical panel, whichever house has, and it just functions like a normal house. The design is such that the long axis of the house faces due south, which happens to be the best views, which is Mount Evans. The nice part of that is then you have about 15% of the floor space of the house as in glass that faces south, and that glass is especially glass that lets the energy of the sun come in and heat up the mass on the inside of the house. The glass is has a high solar heat gain coefficient, so it allows the sun to come through the glass, heat up the mass inside of the house, and then the windows don't let that heat leave the house, or lets little of that heat leave the house. Heat from the home, the primary heat source is the passive solar design. That provides my heat 95% of the year. If we have several cloudy days in a row, then I have two backup sources. The first backup source that I normally use is the fireplace. And actually, I never really need to use the boiler for additional heat unless I have a large amount of guests, and then I will use the third backup system, which is a radiant heating system. The radiant heat tubing runs through the acid-stained concrete floors throughout the house. Works just like a normal radiant heating system for a home, and it is charged, or the heat is generated by a boiler, which I have a propane tank in the back. The hot water system comes from those two panels that we talked about earlier in the back. The hot water comes into the inside of the house from those two panels. This little pump is charged by the sun through a small photovoltaic panel, which produces electricity. That electricity is generated when there's enough sun to generate that electricity. Is when the panels outside are hot enough that hot water starts circulating. Very simple system. Hot water comes through this tank, runs through a coil, goes back out to those panels, and it will produce hot water at 160 degrees, so very extreme hot water. If we do have a number of cloudy days, the system is automated, where there's another coil at the top and there's a thermostat, so if the hot water gets below a certain temperature,
It's set at 105 degrees, which is adjustable. The boiler will kick on and then provides supplemental hot water for the house. So it's an invisible system to the normal user, and you'll never or hardly ever run out of any hot water in the house. It's almost an unlimited supply of hot water.